this is Big Talk Big Game. Once again, man, each and every Thursday, Big Talk Big Game is coming to you live, man.
And direct.
You feel me? Hey, this is your boy, D-Rail.
And I go by the name of Lee. What up?
Hey, man, once again, Big Talk Big Game is here for you. Give you that live entertainment show that you always been wanting. You got, you know what I'm saying, the holiday week that just happened with Christmas. We coming back around on a new year. 2022 is coming up on us, man, and definitely you want to make sure you go into the year off right. You feel me? So make sure you get all the old stuff out the way. Make sure you leave all the past in the past. Going to 2022 with a fresh start, new beginnings, new life. You know what I'm saying? So make sure you remember that going into 2022. You feel me?
42.
Man, Big Talk Big Game. This is our last show of 2021. So we want to definitely thank everybody that's been staying loyal, watching us each and every Thursday from beginning to the end.
Yep. 2022 about to bring in some newness.
You feel me?
Hot
you
stuff,
feel
man. Me? Stick with us, man. Hip Hop Network, man. Big Talk, Big Game. We collaborating. We in here, man. What you got to say about it,
man? I'm going hard, nigga. I ain't gonna lie. I'm lazy as hell. I got some shit started, and then I just slacked off. You feel me? But when I tell you, I'm at you niggas' neck.
It's a reset, baby.
22, the sequel. Come on, man.
Man, hey, no sense. So before we get into our show, man, I definitely want to go across the room, you know what I'm saying, for my co-hosts or whatnot with Big Talk Big Game. And ask y'all, everybody always has a New Year resolution, right?
I ain't doing nothing about it.
You know what I'm saying? But I mean, everybody always going to New Year, like, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to join a fitness club, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to lose some weight, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to get more fit, I'm going to eat right or whatnot. And it's always starting off good in the month of January.
Yeah. Okay.
By the time February get here.
By the time January 6th.
That's why I had on that wrinkle. I was like, hey, what's stopping you from your goals, man? This goal setting season right now.
Oh, man. Like, I'm talking about dog. Like, it's like, it never fails. Like, people going to the new year with a resolution, with a plan, a strong plan.
At least you try.
I'm going to pay this first month of LA Fitness, and then boom. It's like the next month you're here. Why you in LA Fitness no more, man? I had some stuff I had to get done, man. You know what I'm saying? So, man, if you're going to set a New Year's resolution, keep it. So I'm going to go across the room. Do you have something that you want to do going into the New Year that you know you're going to keep?
I'm going to be real with you. This New Year ran up on me so quick, boy. I ain't even think about no New Year's resolution, man. Y'all let us know yours, though, with the 470-387-1161. Help me out.
You feel me?
Because I don't have a resolution. I'm going to be honest with you. I think probably a couple years ago, I just kind of stopped doing resolutions. Probably because of that. You know what I'm saying? You know, but some people don't follow through with it or whatever. But get something started, man. I don't got one at all, man.
What about you, Ekan? What you got, man?
I told you, man, I'm just going into the New Year doing shit I'm supposed to do. I'm not going, you know what I'm saying, slack up. Like, this year, I started doing comedy. Was good at it, you know what I'm saying? Progress a lot. And then at some point, I just stopped, you feel me? So it's, I ain't even got no good reason why I stopped. I just stopped, you feel me? So I'm going into a more focused mode, you know what I'm saying? Planning out, finishing everything I start. That's what I'm doing.
Okay.
Okay.
What about you? Well, I'm going to tell y'all right now, my New Year's resolution, I feel like I'm speaking for the group.
Okay.
You're going to become a Falcons fan.
Hell no. But I want us to go into this year really turning Big Talk Big Game into what we always wanted it to turn into. You know, we have to really go extra hard in 2022. And my goal is to have this as our own income that's coming in. Instead of trying to get away from the corporation.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying? Let this be our income. You
that's
know,
a good ass resolution.
We always talk about, you know, we got dreams. We want this to be big. We want this to be, you know what I'm saying? We want to be able to set stuff up and set good things up for our families and close loved ones and whatnot. You know, let's go into 2022, keeping that mindset. Let's really go out here, grind hard, get it. Let's be and put our faces in the places, man. Let's really get to this because Big Talk Big Game is a great platform for us. Let's turn it to what it is. Big Talk Big Game. Let's make this big.
Let's do it, man.
Let's make this big. Let's go into 22 to make this big.
Shout out to all y'all because y'all helping that dream come true.
Yeah, you is. There you is.
Y'all keep listening, keep commenting, keep subscribing, man. Tell your people about it, man. and we gonna push this thing, man. That's all it is, man. I think every resolution really should be a daily thing. You should have a resolution every day.
Oh man, every day.
I mean, every day you should be getting better than the day before. You know what I'm saying? So
every day.
That's what it is.
Yes sir. So you know what I'm saying? Once again, this is Big Talk Big Game, coming to you live each and every Thursday. And now we are on the Hip Hop Network TV. You feel me?
Hey, so Hip Hop Network making moves, boy.
I'm trying to tell you, man. So if you miss a live show, don't worry. You still got a chance to go to YouTube on Big Talk Big Game or go to Hip Hop Network TV. That's the THEHHN.TV. And you can also watch our previous shows as well, man.
Yeah, and if y'all need any help, man, logging in or becoming a citizen of the Hip Hop Network, man, hit us up, man. Big Talk Big Game Podcast at gmail.com, man. We help you work through that, man. But it's real simple. And it's plenty of stuff on the Hip Hop Network, on the platform, man, to watch and get into, including us.
Right.
We got extra content, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's an extra 30 minutes that we put on the network for the population, despite what we do live for y'all.
There it is.
So there's plenty of ways to access us, plenty of ways to
get to us. And it's merch.
There it is. So, you know what I'm saying? So, I want to start off by saying, like, once again, this is a national day.
Yeah.
The last national day of 2021 Big Talk Big Game show. And I apologize, people. I apologize. I was supposed to bring y'all this, but you know, I apologize, especially you, E-Cal, because this would have brought back memories.
It's Chester's Day.
Today is National Bacon Day.
Oh,
Bacon Day.
Man, and in my mind, I thought about it all week. I said, I'm going to stop at a Checkers, and I'm going to grab us a Bacon Zilla.
My boy.
Man, and I forgot all about it because when you called me, you threw me off with that Falcons hat about stopping at the gas station and whatnot. You threw me off with that. You know what I'm saying? So I was just thinking about that. As you see, I didn't wear one because I couldn't find one at the gas station. You know what I'm saying? So
that's because they won't buy you with the gas station. You might buy the Jets hat at a BP, but you ain't going to find no damn Atlanta Falcons hat, though.
They had Georgia Bulldogs. They even had Miami Heat hats.
What gas station you
I was at a Chevron. But they didn't have no Falcons hat, though, man. They had a Bass Pro fishing hat. But they didn't have no Falcons hat, man. So I look, but I'm gonna make sure I have it. I'm gonna have it for y'all, man. Going into the new year, I'm gonna have that Bacon Zilla from Checkers. If you're gonna go get a Bacon Zilla or Baconator from Wendy's, you know what I'm saying? If you're gonna go get a, you know what I'm saying?
Y'all get y'all some turkey bacon.
There it is. He said belt bacon. Yes, sir. But like we always do each and every Thursday, we got a wonderful show for y'all. We got a lot of material. We got Mr. Lee's Rankum coming to you that be lit every time. You know what I'm saying? We got E-Cal's Who's Capping. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm telling you, like the cap, who's capping? You feel me?
Yeah.
We got that question of the day. I'm telling you, once again, this is the last Who's Capping, Who's Rankum, Lee's Rankum, and the question of the day for y'all of this year. So, you know what I'm saying? Get ready. And we also got a mini version. Because why? Because this year is the last year of all this. And we're about to turn up. I'm telling you, this mini verse is about to get you out of your seat. So make sure you get ready for that as well. You know what I'm saying? So without further ado, we're going to definitely get into this hot topics of the day. You know what I'm saying? That's definitely going around in the world today.
What's happening?
You know what I'm saying? So everybody's always been talking lately about this COVID and shutting stuff down and whatnot, man.
That's the thing.
I don't understand why they should shut stuff down, because if you shut it, okay, you're shutting it down to try to get a grasp on it again, try to bring the numbers down. But when everybody come back out again, the numbers going to shoot right back up again. So I don't see the point of even shutting down, period, when you know it's going to come right back up again. We're going to be right back in the same boat.
I think the purpose of shutting it down is to stop the spread. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you cancel something out, keep it in the bubble, it ain't going to spread as far as much. Versus you got it. Now you at the football games, you at the grocery store
section.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
I mean, but that comes with an inner, you know what I'm saying? That comes with an inner thought of that person. That person is not worried about anybody else. They just worried about themselves. As long as they out there going to get what they need to get and then go back home, they good. Knowing that they got the COVID. But now NBA, NFL, it's like, man, what's the point?
Well, I see the post that said Byron ain't did nothing. Big T would have shut it down. Took us out to dinner, gave us a stimulus, and put some more money in our pocket.
You mean they're going to give us another stimulus?
Yep.
You know, and I was thinking about that. I was like, 'cause I know they only did it for 6 months, so is it supposed to be going on again next month, too?
You talking about the child tax?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I consider my stimulus. Hey, you know what I'm saying? Because I was begging on that.
Listen, boy, that child tax credit paid a million dollars to insurance, but that ain't
collect. You know what I mean?
Right. So is it still going to come?
Oh, no. Insurance
done. That's done.
But the insurance will do on the 15th. You get when that CTC got
the 15th.
On the 15th.
Man, they stopped it, though.
Oh, that's it, man. It was the 2021. Just like you just said, 2021 and done.
Hey, they might need to shut some shit down.
Hey, if y'all gonna bring them stimulus back, then go and shut it down then. Y'all gonna bring it back. You know what I'm saying? Go and shut it down. You know what I'm saying? Also in the news, you know what I'm saying? Right. We definitely want to give our prayers and thoughts and condolences to the family of John Madden. You know what I'm saying?
Man. Oh, yeah.
John Madden passed earlier this week. Game? See, I think that's gonna make it even more memorable. Because now more people
are going to be, of course, right. Dedicated to him. Yeah.
And that's going to make people more people buy that now. Just because of that.
It's going to be that one. That's what they're going to buy.
Yeah, yeah. I'm, matter of fact, I give it the next 2 years, people going to buy it. The next 2 years. Now, the third year, they probably going to be like, oh, okay, I'm good.
They're going to keep doing it. You got family.
They're going to keep making the game. I'm talking about people buying it, though. They're going to keep making games, you know what I'm saying?
People going to still buy it.
I know I'm going to buy it. I buy it every year. I got all Mac.
My thing is, it's going to be somebody else's voice on it.
They need to go ahead and get that crossplay.
I don't think his voice is on there no more.
You know what? That's right.
His voice ain't on there.
They need to get that crossplay.
Right. So Xbox, PS5, make sure y'all get crossplay on the Madden. I'm telling you. You get crossplay on the Madden, I'm telling you. Watch how y'all numbers grow. I try your numbers grow, man.
Because when they added it to Call of Duty.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Other games have got crossplay going on. So
yeah, Fortnite crossplay. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
It's going there.
Yeah. So also, man.
Hey, you can't even say that shit, man. I ain't even got no. I don't even play this on Xbox. Hey, put the PlayStation in. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. If I had my PlayStation.
Right. Man, also, you know what I'm saying? What I'm saying, let everybody know. D-Rail still has a shot, y'all. I still got a shot. Megan Good just got a divorce. I still got a shot, y'all. I still got a shot. I'm telling you, man, that's my celebrity crush. I'm letting y'all know right now. I still got a shot, y'all. I'm letting you know right now.
What
they, like any other celebrity, they were saying stuff like, you know, that. Like any other celebrity couple that's married or together, they were saying that they didn't really see each other a lot.
Oh, okay.
He was always here, she was always there, and she said, and he said that what happened is that when they finally was able to see each other, it was only for like a couple of hours, and then boom, somebody gone again.
You know what I'm saying? Hey,
man, see you
in a minute.
Right.
I'm
calling bullshit on that, man. I'm calling bullshit. Because y'all knew that from jump, right? You knew that before you got married.
Yeah,
you've been married for years.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Now all of a sudden it's a surprise. Something happened.
Hey,
we going to hear about it later.
Did wife leave?
She might be gone now.
Hey, she know. She even brought it to my attention. You know what I'm saying? So that let you know what it is. Yeah.
That's a tip. If she brought it to you, what's her name? Megan Knight. Megan sometimes good and broke up with her nigga. What you think about that,
Darrell,
huh?
Well, hey, I feel like I passed the test.
Nah, you go.
No, you fail. Sound like y'all got an open relationship.
You supposed to say, you my Megan good, baby.
Hey, she know that, no, baby. Said, baby, you my Megan. She know that. She
you
know
my
that.
Megan better baby. Is what you're supposed to go with.
There, no, say, there you go. You my Megan best.
Just don't
say it. You know what I'm saying? There it is. You my Megan best. Nah. You know what I'm saying? She know I love you. I love you, baby. You know I love you. You know what I'm saying? Man. Also, you know what I'm saying? Moving on to the news. The peace drop has been canceled in Atlanta.
I
I was looking forward to that, man. I wanted to go to that.
I've been here 30 years. You ain't never been to a beat drop.
Kissing bitches and all that over there, man. Shit. Back in, see, this was back in like 2003, 2004. It was good to go at that time. Now you get salmonella, COVID, Wuhan vaccine, all that shit. You do this shit now. Oh, I'm the only person that kissed somebody on New Year's Eve? Back in them single days?
Hey, I'm happy to go before 2003.
That nigga
said, "Kiss the shit." That's what it was. Hey, J-Rock, you remember that? You remember that, man?
Oh man, he was out there in them streets.
But all them pages out there, boy.
Asses dropped. Panties dropped.
Hey, you can kiss a stranger.
I mean, if you're game tight, you don't know what you're for, little man.
Y'all ain't never kissed a stranger in the club or nothing. Man, no. How long before you kiss somebody? I have. I ain't gonna lie.
How long before you kiss somebody?
I gotta get the dorm at least three goddamn days.
Hey,
if you're non-exclusive, hold on. So you ain't had no one night stands.
I ain't trying to.
We rest our case.
But you don't kiss on one night stands.
Why not?
Come straight to the smash.
Okay, but you kiss him. Why you smash it sometimes?
You kiss at some point.
Right. You kiss it at some point.
Bro, maybe not on a one-night stand.
No.
Not on a one-night stand.
He kissing on a one-night stand.
Man, one-night stand.
That's too bad.
One-night stand. I did.
Y'all nigga making I love.
You already making love on a
one-night
stand.
Hey, because I'm going to tell you right now, on the one-night stands, boy, you ain't never going to see them no more. It ain't going to never happen no more, so I'm going to go all in.
You gonna do everything. So you gonna kiss and get mono, and you ain't gonna be able to tell him. Bitch, you gotta be mono, cause you ain't gonna be able to see her again. Hey, you right. I had the mono, cause I was doing the mono. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't doing the mono. Also, man, the news. I learned this. That's why we immune to COVID right now. Shit like that. Nigga, got it all. We started this shit.
Oh man, y'all boys.
Hey,
funny.
What Mike gonna say?
Not that
for this shit too.
Oh man,
Mike, I'm trying to see what that's about. I ain't never seen that shit. Where the fat bitch is at?
Y'all boys funny. Y'all boys hilarious. Man, move it on, man. You know they got an actual flying human jet pack, man. Now.
Yeah. I feel like they had that before.
$375,000 you can buy.
Man, I thought you were gonna say $375,000. I'm talking about all in one, boy. I'm about to say that's gonna be on the next show.
We apply to you.
Oh man, $375. I mean, $375,000.
Well, stop playing with me, man. Huh?
Stop playing with me.
Hey, so did y'all hear about the girl that's in jail that went viral that people trying to pay for her bail now?
Where'd she go to jail?
Oh, the cute chick.
Prison bank?
You know what I'm saying?
These niggas is down bad.
I don't give a fuck how cute you is.
She's down somewhere at a gas station. Man.
Y'all need to be down bad, man. Ain't no way.
She's down somewhere at a gas station. So, you know what I'm saying? So, she got 7 years.
Now too.
Shebang, you posted this.
If you know, you know. Them shebangs.
But see, I thought the shebangs were only in jail.
They got out. They did their time.
They had a release.
They did their time.
They out now. Them niggas did their time. Wow.
There's a lot going on, man. And while we at it and talking about stuff going on, man, we got to talk about this week in history. hip hop history. Uh-oh. Pimp C was born this week. Y'all know about it.
Happy birthday, Pimp C.
Sweet Jones.
Yeah. Happy birthday, Pimp C.
LeBron James was born this week.
Yep. LeBron. Oh, yep.
When was the talent?
The Chosen.
Yep. Also, happy birthday, Mom. Your birthday was this past Monday. Happy birthday, Mom.
Happy birthday, Andre.
You know what I'm saying? Your birthday was this past. Happy birthday, Sadie. Your birthday was this past Tuesday. You know what I'm saying? Two of our loyal watchers and viewers or whatnot, as always. You know what I'm saying?
Happy birthday, man. Happy birthday, too.
Yeah, definitely. Happy.
Tiger Woods had a birthday. Tiger Woods, y'all. Mr. McDowell had a birthday. Shout out John Amos.
This man said Mr. McDowell.
You know, they got the golden arcs.
This man said Mr. McDowell.
Denzel Washington birthday this week.
Yeah, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Denzel, that y'all favorite actor?
No.
Why not?
No.
To me,
play the same character.
Yes.
Yeah, he play the same person. Yeah. He don't give me different he don't give me different.
No variety.
Personality, personas, or whatnot.
Monotone, still body speech.
You got your cornbread, you got your macaroni and cheese.
If you don't have that final swing, this is what I'm talking about right here. If you're going to get some money, you have to go around the corner. You can't just stay.
You got food on the table, right? You got clothes on your back, right?
Not one place is the day I'm supposed to fucking live.
Denzel Washington, man.
Denzel,
they got
man.
Tank, your boy, the singer.
His birthday this week?
His birthday this week.
Okay.
His birthday this week.
Tank. You said Tank?
We had Tank. We had Tank versus Jamie Foxx a couple weeks ago, mini versus.
Tank. Exactly. You heard what I said.
Tank. That's Mr. Gucci. Gucci.
Hey, also, you know what I'm saying? We definitely want to say, man, if you're trying to get some of the merch, Big Talk Big Game has that merch for you, you know what I'm saying? So definitely holler us on IG, Facebook, Instagram, or you know what I'm saying? Definitely holler us on email as well at BigTalkBigGamePodcast@gmail.com, man. Definitely hit us. So we got every size, we got every color for your hoodies and shirts. Hats coming soon, you feel me?
And see you big dudes, we working on the six, man.
They made the order. We can get them together.
Right. They are made to order. They are made to order.
Also, Ecstasy from Houdini passed away last year.
Oh, man.
No.
You know, friends, how many of us have been?
Houdini is about it.
I didn't know that.
Also, this is the week anniversary of when J-Lo and Puffy got arrested. Remember that?
Oh.
J-Lo and Puffy got arrested. J-Lo got off, though. Puffy got the weapon.
Puffy got off. Shine didn't get off.
No, I think that was a different situation.
Okay.
And one last thing for the history. On this week in December of 2019, the World Health Organization first learned of a viral pneumonia cases in Wuhan, China. The disease was later determined to be COVID-19. Y'all might have heard of it, which became the global pandemic. So that's all the history we got for you.
There it is, man.
Yeah. I'm saying, there it is. If it weren't for COVID, who wouldn't realize how dirty the fucking America is?
You're probably right.
Niggas got up science on my son. Now we're cleaning after every guest. What the fuck were you doing before?
That's true.
That's nasty as hell.
That is
said,
true.
Now we're cleaning after every guest. What? Happened to all you know, yeah, you're
did
right.
Y'all know, like when COVID happened, like everything that was 24 hours stopped being 24 hours. All the time.
Yeah,
like, you can't even go to Waffle House anytime.
That's the main shit that get on my nerve, man. I can't go to Waffle House,
man. Yeah. You go to Waffle House, oh man, we closed right now. What?
I thought Waffle House was 24.
We all just take it to go orders, man. Nobody want this shit to go. I'm trying to sit down, sit this liquor off, eat this food. And then go home to my wife.
There it is.
Walmart started closing that crazy ass 10:30, 11 o'clock. We closed.
Well, you know what? I'm going to tell you.
Where I'm going to be 24/7.
I'm going to tell you who should have closed. And that's UPS. Atlanta UPS driver was kidnapped at 3 a.m.
Man, that is a fucking.
Tied up in the back of his tractor trailer. And they stole the packages out the truck.
What was the truck found?
Donald Lee Highway Parkway.
That was a fucking inside job. That was an
West
inside.
Side Atlanta, what's up?
Nigga said, don't fuck that guy in the kitchen to the truck. I'm finna do that now. Look, I know they gonna have some PS5 with some shit on the shit. We can split the shit.
That nigga selling three that ways. Shit right 50, now.
50-50, bro. So look, I'm going to set it up because they going to be asking me questions. You know, they got the truck on me. So like, when I get to the red light, get my
rope. I do it wrong. You feel me? So about this time, I
just get the CVS. I need to flick it on down to the goddamn athlete flick. So when I get down there, y'all niggas step in front of me. I got a smash on the brake. They got a camera on me. And then y'all niggas fake rob me. Slap me with the pistol. All that. You know
yeah, because they didn't tie them up.
Man. Right. They didn't tie them up in the back of the truck, man. Tied.
And look, they would have just knocked you out.
Listen, unharmed.
Yeah. Yeah. He did the best. Hey man, don't hit me too hard. Goddamn, man. They can't even find no bruises on me.
Y'all need to knock me the fuck out. I'm beating y'all ass. When I get back to the truck,
I know exactly where y'all stay.
They do that shit on the west side, and then they come sell the shit on the east side.
Oh, man.
I need y'all to clean this bitch out.
Hollywood.
Because look, they got man. Insurance on their package.
Right, right.
Right. By the flames.
Right.
That's where it was.
This is Big Talk Big Game,
Hip-hop
man.
Network, baby,
you feel me? Hip Hop Network, you feel me? Hey, man, if you want to call in and say something on the Big Talk Big Game, just call in with this number, which is 470-387-1161. Once again, the number is
470-387-1161.
Man, definitely. Like right, right. Right. That nigga had all the details. Man, he had all the details, man. You know what I'm saying? Well, Mr. E. Cal, you know what I'm saying? We're going to definitely get right on to it, man. I feel like, you know what I'm saying? I need to see if I can bounce back with this who's captain. You feel me?
We're going to see if you can bounce back, man.
Double or nothing?
Hey, man, help us out with
double
the who's captain, man.
Double or nothing. What do you mean?
Like, that means that if I still don't get both on right, that means you ain't got to get the captain.
Ooh, let's do it. Let's shake it on it.
Hold on. Oh, hold man. On. Somebody be on the other end of that.
Let's shake on
so that what mean, if you that, do that, get that, them all the way right?
If I do get them all the way right, then that means you got to get the cap and the jersey.
Shit.
How good is your
fuck it. Let go. Let go.
Shake on it.
There let go. There you go. I'm with it. Come on, I'm back out now. Don't jet back now.
We gonna set that bet up for 2022. Let's get it. We gonna
so is it for this?
No, it ain't for this one. It ain't for this one. You know, so we gonna set that bet up.
For hey man, help us out with the who's cabin, man. Y'all don't be no help. Y'all right. Be getting it right.
Right. Y'all don't know what I'm saying. Y'all be all over the place. I'm looking at y'all comments, and then I'm listening to what my mind is saying, and then I'm listening to what Lee is saying over here, trying to figure it out. You know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to figure it all out, man. You know what I'm saying?
Overthink.
You gonna overthink it?
Yeah.
I hear
you. Phone deleted.
My phone may have deleted it, man. I had two good ones.
Man, it's all good. It's all good. We don't say we'll pick it up when you find it. You know what I'm saying? We're going to the question of the day. So you know what I'm saying? So like I told y'all before, you know what I'm saying? I want y'all to buckle your seats. Hold on tight because this is a good question. I feel like could be, you know what I'm saying?
Question
so
okay.
Question of the day. And this may mainly speak to women.
Here we go.
It can speak to men probably, but mainly it may speak to women though. You know what I'm saying? So can you fuck your way to the top?
That's the phone number is 470-387-1161.
Can you fuck your way to the top?
Fat boy, what up?
That's the question of the day. Can you fuck your way to the top?
Wait a minute.
I mean, I'm just saying, can you fuck your way to the top? I mean, I'm just, because you got to realize, think about it. There's a lot of sexy women in the world today.
Okay.
Oh,
and shit. Do you honestly feel like that they got their way to the top based on them just grinding? Or do you feel like they got their way to the top because who they might have fucked or what they look like?
Well, they finna beat your ass.
Now I ain't saying everybody is like that. I'm just asking the question.
Have you tried?
Can you fuck your way to the top? Can you fuck your way to the top?
I bet you there's some people. It's listen women out here to have.
Listen,
according to Talisa, yeah, people do it all the time. I agree. I think there are some people out there that fuck their way to the top. That's the only way they can get there because, you know what I'm saying, depending on if you're a lady especially, if you fuck a big-time person that's up there, they're going to keep you there. as long as you still giving them what they want and need, they going to keep you there. So you basically technically at the top. Now, are you going to stay at the top is a whole different question. Because now you got to have game. Now you got to figure out, okay, what you bring to the table besides sex. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, can you fuck your way to the top? Or is people just positioning themselves to get to the top?
Are you saying anybody or women in general?
Just anybody. I mean, that's why I say it mostly speaks for women, because most of the time that's what you see on Instagram with these, you know what I'm saying, fake booties. And, you know what I'm saying, made up women or whatnot, you know what I'm saying? They fucking some big CEO, you know what I'm saying? So
if you fucking your boss and steal a kudom.
Have anybody ever fucked their boss? Have y'all fucked y'all bosses?
Yo, coochie trash.
I'm just saying. Can you fuck your way to the top? You know what I'm saying? I bet you there are some women that we know right now to this day.
They say men do it too.
And I agree. Excuse me. I'm not saying that they don't. I agree. I'm just saying, though, is it true that you can fuck your way to the top? Or do y'all feel like that people just positioning themselves in good positions
to go to the top? But there's some people that skip the positioning and go to another position to get up top.
So I'm asking you, can someone fuck their way to the top?
Yeah.
Do you feel like it's more fucking way to the top, or you feel like people position themselves to the top?
I think in most cases people do some shit to get to the top. Besides,
what's do shit though? I don't know. Let's be specific. You know what I'm saying? This is big talk, big game. We talk that talk and we walk that walk. You feel me? So let it be known.
It's hard working that they get their way to the top, but it's some bitches that slide through too.
Okay. How the fuck you be coming up with these?
None of you don't. Man. Can you fuck your way to the top?
I wonder how many people have been in that position where it was offered to them and they pulled like a stone from set it off.
See what I'm saying? Hey, you know what I'm saying?
I need my money.
Hey, what if they only had one opportunity and it was that time for the money?
With that mouth beat up.
What was old boy name that he had?
You ain't going nowhere. Period.
What was his name? What was his name in the Set It Off movie that she fucked? Was it Frank?
It might have been Frank.
I'm in the bind, Nate.
You're Nate. Yeah. Nate. I'm in the bind, Nate. I really need this money. Another time. Hit that car drive. Another time. And then all you heard was. You know what I'm saying? So basically, yeah, can you fuck your way to the top? I mean, like I said, E-Cap, can you?
I don't know.
Man, don't say no. You know, just yes
know,
or no. What do you feel
See,
like?
I ain't never been.
What?
From, you ain't never been offered.
From,
I ain't never been in a position to promote.
No, I'm just saying. But from what you may feel and what you may know, looking at certain people, this is a guess. You may not know, but what do you feel like, or what do you think that they may be doing it, or I don't think nobody doing. Like, what do you feel?
Somebody somewhere doing it.
What do you feel?
It's possible, yeah.
Because you know what?
It's possible.
Money and pussy make the world go round.
It do.
Because you know, that's powerful. Man.
Pussy is powerful, man.
It do. And like,
dudes do crazy dumb shit. You know what I'm saying? Look at Epstein. You know the old girl.
Penis is a pretty. It's starting
with a P.
It's
starting with a P.
Tool.
But then pussy starting with P too. But a
pussy.
Pussy.
Of course.
Well, for me, yeah, of course. Pussy all course. Day, all across the board.
Cause men do dumb shit for pussy. Look at Epstein and them. Then the old girl, his homegirl, went to jail. Just got convicted. She can get up to like 70 years for getting bitches to fuck him. So she can move up. So she wasn't giving up
there
the pussy.
There you go, yep.
She was finding pussy.
So yep. You feel like,
right, because if she fucking somebody like, let me think. Well, she can't fuck R. Cutty.
She got to fuck the warden. He in there too.
He in there too. So
what if the warden like that old ass nigga on the longest yard?
Oh man. Or like on Shawshank Redemption, the dude was working in the library with the little bird. You know what I'm saying? But hey, you know what I'm saying? I feel like that's a good, valid question. Can you fuck your way to the top? Yes. Call in to let us know, man. The number is
470-387-1161.
Once again, the number here, the Big Talk Big Game, is
470-387-1161.
Can you fuck your way to the top? Or is people really positioning themselves to get to the top? You know what I'm saying? And like I said, once you get there, now do you feel like that as long as you consistently fucking this person, do you feel like you're gonna stay there with it? Or do you feel like now the game is on? Now you gotta figure out what your mindset is about, what your wordplay is about, you know what I'm saying? Or do you feel like they're gonna always stay at the top because they said he fucked?
I mean, you got a nice little jump start.
We gotta call him. Yo, yo, this is Big Talk Big Game. Yo, yo, this is Big Talk Big Game. Yo, yo.
What's going on, fat boy?
Now, you know we can't hear this guy. You know what I'm saying? We can't hear this guy at all.
Hold on, fat boy. Give me 1 second. Hold on, fat boy. We're going to get you right.
Yo, fat boy, what's going on? Can't hear fat boy.
Yeah,
fat boy.
Hey, call back in. Can you fuck your way to the top though? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's a really good question. Can you fuck your way to the top, or can you just position yourself to get to the top? That's the question of the day. You know what I'm saying? I feel like, you know, a lot of people are probably gonna say yes. They really don't want to say yes, but they know deep down it's true. You know, they know deep down it's true.
There's certain perks, man. You hitting the right person. Hey, you in there.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, and that's true. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's definitely true. You know what I'm saying? Now, do you feel like that eventually it dies down? Or do you feel like, you know, that they still going to keep, they going to always stay at the top, whether they keep messing with them or not?
It dies down.
Most definitely it dies down. Because ain't no pussy like new pussy.
Exactly. That's exactly where I was going.
Okay, here we go. We ready? Let's see.
We going to see.
Yo, yo, this is Big Talk Big Game.
What's up, press one.
Two. Yo, yo, this is Big Talk Big Game.
Hey, you hear me now?
Yes, I got you on speaker. What's good, man? What's good?
I felt like I was speaking at the same time, but you couldn't hear me, but I am. Oh, it ain't saying 9 o'clock. Back in the day, spring hit you the many times it's 9 o'clock.
Oh, yeah?
The many times.
What's up? Hey,
today
ain't nobody. Way to the top. And I'm
going to
just give you one name and one name
only,
because you wrote a book about it. Kareem.
Superhead.
Kareem.
Who?
Superhead.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I know a Superhead. I don't know her real name.
Hey, she kind
of
sucked her way to the top.
Yeah, she kind of sucked her way to the top. You know what I'm saying?
Same
she
name,
she.
Same.
Guess what? I'm all in.
Fat boy say he's
yes,
all
sir.
In.
Yes, sir. He all in. Fat boy say he's all in.
And given the opportunity.
What was that? Dude, that sound like what was that? One of donuts, the white puff donut. Okay.
They call us all anyway. Let me be a dog and a horse.
There it is. Appreciate you calling in, though, fat boy. Appreciate you, man. Appreciate you.
Walking your way to the top.
There it is. Big talk, big game. You feel me? Yes, sir. That was fat boy, man. He definitely said, yeah, you can fuck your way to the top, man. He said one name that came out was Superhead.
Let me ask you this. What y'all think Amber Rose? Did she fuck her way to the top?
I think she fucked her way to the middle.
She
fucked it over
to Nick Cannon,
man.
Nick Cannon fucked everybody.
Kanye West.
She left Kanye West.
To go with Wiz Khalifa.
And then went to Nick Cannon. That's why I say she fucked her way to the middle. Like, she was at the top, and then she started to decline.
We just said they declined.
Who you supposed to fuck after Kanye West?
So, you think Kanye West bigger than Nick Cannon?
Most definitely.
I'm just asking. I ain't said he won. I'm just saying. Most you know what I'm saying? Definitely. Because Nick Cannon got his hands on everything.
Nick Cannon got some juice.
Right. He got his hands on everything. Like, he got his hands on everything.
What's the last Nick Cannon movie you said?
Nick Cannon did last movie.
All right, with the last production,
with the first movie Wild Kanye out. Did.
You don't have to do more. He got Kanye West is nominated for 7 Stellar Awards.
But
Nick that's Cannon, only for gospel artists.
Nick Cannon got wildin' out. Okay. He didn't host America's Got Talent.
Then he got 5.
Then he now he's hosting The Masked Singer.
Then he got 5.
No, he don't.
Yes, he did.
No, he didn't. He's still on that. He's still on that. They take me to do a 7th season with this guy.
Masked Singer?
Yes.
I thought he, after that,
he never got fired from Masked Singer.
He lost Wildin' Out, and they brought that back.
He never got that. Fired from Masked Singer. He never lost Masked Singer. He never lost that. Only thing he lost was America's Got Talent.
So you think Nick got more money than Kanye?
I ain't said that. I ain't never looked at their salaries or whatnot. I'm just
saying.
Kanye got more money.
That's what I'm saying. If Nick got his hands on, that don't mean nothing. Just because he got his hand on everything. I didn't buy. Listen, you can have all the pink. You can have all the sky blue, all the orange. But as long as I got Boardwalk and Park Place.
So
I was wondering where that was going.
So are you telling me that in order to have a bigger name, you got to have more money? Or are you saying that your bigger name means that more people know you? Which one is it?
It's more money.
So if that's the case, then Bill Gates should be bigger than Kanye then, right?
He should be.
But he ain't got no bigger name. Like, people don't really talk about Bill Gates.
Bill Gates got a bigger name.
Most definitely.
People don't really talk about Bill Gates.
You ain't know Bill Gates, though.
Ain't nobody talking about Bill Gates.
Just like they know Kanye.
But we know
So do they talk about the CEO of Amazon?
You talking about Jeff Bezos?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He may be got more money. He may be, you know what I'm saying, bigger as far as money-wise, but as far as fame-wise...
Well, fame and money are two different things.
And that's why I say, what we talking about? We talking about fame or we talking about money?
Money.
You know what I'm saying? Money.
So the more money you make makes you bigger.
More money, more power.
Okay.
Listen.
I mean, because there's a lot of people out there that got a lot of money.
Listen.
But that don't mean that I know them. Like, I'm always seeing them in the spotlight. Like,
man, you finna holler at
this
shit, right? You see, yo. Trying to fuck her to get her to the top, right? Since we staying on subject. I'm saying, baby, look, you fuck me, I'm taking you to the top, and I'm giving you 7,000. You said, you fuck me, I'm taking you to the top, and I'm giving you 7 million. Now, we both in the same position. Who you think she gonna fuck?
She gonna cut you because it's more money.
More money, more power.
No, what I'm saying is this. Okay, let's say we both giving her the same amount, though. We both giving her 7 million.
Okay.
Now it's gonna come into who got more fame, because Kanye could get 7 million.
Prince the producer.
And Jeff Bezos could get 7 million, but who you think she's gonna fuck with more? She's gonna probably go to Kanye because he's more famous. People see him all the time; they know who he is for real.
But that don't mean he's more famous.
Why not?
That don't mean he's more famous.
Why not?
When the last time you heard about?
When's the last time you heard about Jeff Bezos?
Larry,
Jeff Bezos is always in the news.
Say right now.
How many Kanye packages you got in your house? Exactly. I rest my case, Your Honor.
Jeff Bezos got long money.
I ain't said it, you know what I'm saying? That
listen, just because you
don't know because you got money. I'm talking about fame and money is two different things.
Listen, just because you hear Kanye West, that's all you gonna know. Kanye, Donda, Yeezy. Jeff Bezos, Amazon.
Okay. Get out Kanye and put Jay-Z there then.
What you saying?
Jeff Bezos, Amazon.
Jay-Z, Tidal, NBA team. What else did he own? He own shit.
Are you what's trying to say that,
hold
Jeff?
Hold on.
No, I'm just saying.
What's your title, right now? What's your title, you tonight?
I ain't got time.
Exactly.
I'm just saying, like,
get that shit out of here.
Fame and money work hand in hand.
That's what I'm saying. Just you know what I'm saying? Like, hands on everything. Just because you got a lot of shit out.
First of all, Jeff Bezos is more famous than Kanye.
I ain't saying he's not. I'm just saying, like, you know what I'm saying? That's why I took Kanye out and put Jay-Z there. So you think a lot of people don't know about Jay-Z.
More people know about Jeff Bezos than Jay-Z.
I guess if you put, you know what I'm saying?
Black people know Jay-Z.
White people know Jay-Z.
White people know Jay-Z. More white people know Jeff Bezos than they know Jay-Z.
I don't I don't know.
Ask an old lady at the grocery store. She don't know Jeff Bezos before she know Jay-Z.
See, now we putting age limits on it now.
I'm talking about people.
We putting age limits on it.
Man, there's so many stipulations.
Jeff Bezos went to the moon and shit. You know Jeff Bezos.
What you mean? Jay-Z owned part of the Brooklyn Nets. What you mean?
Everybody don't give a damn about basketball.
Man, hey, man, a lot of people do, though. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know what we're talking about.
A lot of people do, man. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, you know what I'm saying? So, we don't get on. You know what I'm saying? Fucking, that's basically what it is.
Who you think will bitch your fuck first? Jeff Bezos or Jay-Z?
I'm going to say Jay-Z.
That'd be a stupid chick.
That's
only because his face is more out there, right?
I'm gonna say Jay-Z.
Fame, because bitches want fame.
Yeah, they just want fame.
I hear what you're saying.
Bitches want fame. They ain't gonna get no fame knowing that you fucking, you fucking Jeff Bezos. Oh, okay. You ain't get no fame from that. You gonna get money from it, but you don't get no fame from it.
You're gonna get fame. You won't get no, it's a difference between black fame and white fame.
You gonna get white fame for Jay-Z.
Not as much white fame as she gonna get from Jeff Bezos.
How was Jeff Bezos?
Doesn't matter when you.
No, it does.
No, because when you got money, they sucking that gummy bar.
That's generational wealth.
They sucking that gummy bar.
I feel you, man. I feel you. Okay,
and
I feel you.
A lot of them that's trying to get up to the top. They're not trying to get famous.
I feel you.
They ain't trying to be famous.
Daryl said, "What about Reggie Bush?" Man, let us know, man, how y'all feel, man. Can you fuck your way to the top? Can you fuck your way to the top?
If you can fuck your way to the middle, you can fuck your way to the top.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
You talking about monopoly. Hey. Fuck your way to get that chance card. You don't know.
So right now, Big Tall Big Game is going to take a quick commercial break for y'all, man. We're going to definitely come back to you. But, man, make sure you stay tuned because Big Tall Big Game has a lot more in store for you, man. Got a lot more coming to you right here in a second. Stay tuned. We back in effect, man.
Hey, Joy, let's talk
you know
about
what I'm saying?
Man.
So, yeah, definitely, you know what I'm saying? I want to appreciate everybody staying tuned in, man, after that commercial break, man. You know what I'm saying? This is Big Talk, Big Gang, coming to you live each and every Thursday at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Like we always say, you know what I'm saying? Make sure you hit the subscribe button on YouTube at Big Talk, Big Gang. If you ain't already a game changer, if you ain't following us on Instagram, subscribe to us on YouTube, follow us on Facebook, Big Talk Big Game Live. I'm telling you, man, make sure you go do that now. Click the button now while you're watching the show now. Man, this is Big Talk Big Game, man. Definitely tell a friend to tell a friend. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and the follow button, man. Big Talk Big Game. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? So, we definitely know what I'm saying. Want to pick it up where we left off a little bit. Just touch it just a little bit more. Can you fuck your way to the top?
That's the question of the day.
Can you fuck your way to the top?
Would you do it?
Man, hey, I'm just saying, I think you can. I think people still do it. I think they are doing it. You know what I'm saying? They are fucking their way to the top. People don't ever want to talk about it, but they know what's going on. I'm going to tell you that now. They know what's going on. Because I can look at a lot of Instagram chicks right now, and I could just tell just by looking at them, like, yep, she fucked somebody to get to that position. She fucked somebody to get to that position. I know she did.
Man.
She fucked somebody to get to that position.
What do you think?
She fucked somebody to get to that position.
Do you think those managers at McDonald's with them bullshit ass attitude fuck somebody?
They fucked the wrong person. That's why they're a manager at McDonald's.
What are we talking about,
y'all? You know what I'm saying?
What are we talking about?
Now, if you wanted to be a district owner of or regional owner of McDonald's, then you know you would have been fucking the right person.
And you can fuck your way to the top.
I tell you what,
riding around.
Bet that shit come with a cost, little boy.
Oh, man. Oh, man. This is Big Talk Big Game, man. We're giving you all that live entertainment. You feel me? So, Mr. Lee, do you have a rank'em for the people, the game changers today?
I got a rank'em for y'all, man. You know my rank'em, man. You know they be about preference. You know what I'm saying? So, once again, ladies and gentlemen, we got a rank'em. And it's about preference. Now, you know. We were once eligible bachelors out here in these streets. You feel me? Like, women value our opinion sometimes. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I'm talking about today, I'm talking about hair.
Okay. Right? Okay.
Hair.
Okay.
Here we go.
We're talking about hair. We're talking about females. It's a lot of money when it comes to hair. You're talking about fucking your way to the top. You got to make sure your hair is right so you can even get the offer to fuck your way to the top. You feel me?
Hey, that was a perfect song. You can fuck your way to the top.
So, a lot of times women will go all out, spend a lot of money. It's super big business to get your hair straight, laid, whatever you got to do. So as men, a lot of times you feel like, okay, women get their hair done for each other sometimes. You know what I'm saying? They want to look good. We always talk about mental health. People want to look good, feel good. They get their hair done. But also, women, let's be real, you get your hair done to impress guys sometimes too, right? Because you want to look good and you want guys to notice you if you're single, if you're married, whatever the case may be.
Right.
So us as fellas, where we come in, I want y'all to rank the sexiest hairstyles.
Okay. Okay.
You feel me?
Ooh, could I know what kind of hairstyle I like? So I know what I don't like either. So yeah.
Okay.
Let's
go. We ranking hairstyles, and you know, women, I know y'all get your hair done for yourselves, but if you want to know how we feel about the type of hair you got, hey, we'll let you know.
But let me ask you this then before you do that. So the women that you may have with the hairstyles, we gotta take their face out
the equation. We talking about hair.
Okay.
Just imagine the hair on somebody that you think is attractive.
Okay.
Because of course you know all of it goes together.
Right. So
we talking about hair. So first hairstyle I got. Braids. Dookie braids, micro braids, braids.
The producer.
Definitely straight. Definitely straight. I'm gonna go with braids second. You know what I'm saying? Cause it all depends on what kind of braids someone got, man. They got them good braids or whatnot, dog. Like, you know, cause see, you can pull braids and it ain't gonna mess up nothing.
Babe, what you laughing for?
You know what I'm saying? You can pull braids and it ain't gonna do nothing. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna go braids. I'm gonna go to curly fro. Curly fro is number three. Yeah, curly fro is number three. Then I'm gonna go dreads four. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go short hair five, then bald six. I don't know if I could do that bald head, man. I don't care how good you look. I don't know if I can have you lower hair than me.
You got that big booty bitch with the bald hair.
I can't have you having lower hair than me, man. Now it may be. Hey. Hey, listen.
Not palm in the back of the head.
Hell no.
Now, listen. Like you just said, you just described the reason why I would say I would, you know what I'm saying, prefer bald head because it's a good fuck. But to actual be with.
She can't have that pack of Hank Frank in the back, though. That's the whole
Me and you can't be at the same bar.
Oh, you can't be out with him.
You know what I'm saying? We can't be at the same bar.
Why not?
Hey, babe, when you going to get us a hair? When the barber going to be cutting our hair together? When this happens? You know what I'm saying? No, we can't be at the same bar. I need you to go to the hair salon. I need to be able to go to the barber shop.
Oh, man. Because
like what Cedric's entertainer said, this is a black man cornerstone. I can't be talking about, you know what I'm saying, barbershop talk while you fucking sitting right there, man.
No, what's different from us being live on Big Talk, Big Game, and your wife watching?
That's a true statement. But go ahead, Lee. What's your rank on that? What's your rank?
Y'all funny as hell. What's your rank? Well, I did this because I wanted to see if y'all can separate the hair from the woman. Because we shallow as hell. Because really, be real with you. It don't matter what her hair looks like. For real.
If she ugly.
If she bad.
Yeah, she bad. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you're right. She bad.
So, ladies, if you look good, it really don't matter. But there are some preferences. I love my natural woman, but that damn straight hair, I don't know what it is about it, boy.
Yeah, straight and jet around. Black. Straight and jet black. Lord have mercy.
Put some color. Oh, I don't give a damn.
Get that black with the brown streak.
Stop.
Ladies, we trying to tell you.
Stop.
Shit.
I tell you, by the time they coming around the corner,
or get the all blonde straight like Monica said.
Yeah, hey, something about that blonde. Blonde have a little bit more fun.
Man.
So I got straight number one.
Something about those earth tones, man.
Yeah, I like all that, man. I like, I'm going to go with the curly fro number two. Something about that wild look, you know what I'm saying? Give me
Before you go, they said they can't hear us.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where you going?
What is that? Facebook?
All of it. Instagram, I mean Facebook, YouTube, and can you hear us?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're gonna keep it going.
Keep it going.
So yeah, so I got the curly look, you know what I'm saying? That wild style. Give me the short look. The short look good. It look good. It's a good look for you. Give me the short. I like braids. Then I'm going dreads. But you gotta have your dreads right too. And then I'm going bald. So that's the hair,
okay,
man. Listen.
Okay.
We like men. Us men like hair for different reasons. A lot of times it got to do with, you know, in the sack. You feel me? You know, that's what it's about.
There it is. You're right.
That's
there
what it's about. But we definitely appreciate the effort of you making yourself look good with your hair. Make yourself look good for yourself. And you know y'all do it for us too. So
there it is.
All right, so the next ranking. Just random shit. So random shit for the end of the year. We talking about the worst things to step on.
Oh. Lego pieces.
The worst things to step on.
Them Lego pieces be boy, they
your phone. Shit.
I want y'all to rank of these items. The worst things to step on.
But them toys at night, boys, shit.
Number one.
I'm gonna get these goddamn toys.
Toys, Legos, cars, baby dolls, all that. You're walking around and coop, 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 coop. This dude look like he about to bust his ass on these things.
Right, look like he about to twist his ankle and everything.
Who the hell left this? I got that thing up there.
Toys. Hell, man.
Number two, you ever have on socks and step in some syrup or something wet or something?
Oh, man.
Shit. You're going to throw your whole foot away.
Stepping on some wet in your socks. Number two. Number three, now this may hit for some of y'all, and some of y'all, it don't even make no difference. Stepping on the scale sometimes.
Damn. Like for real?
Hey, real talk.
Stepping on that damn when you got face to face reality up in here.
I need a special scale because the one that just be in the bathroom, digital, all them shit say error. Like,
error.
This shit ain't working out. This ain't for you.
Stepping on the scale. We ranking worst things to step on, worst to best.
Okay.
Next thing, you go from stepping on the scale to stepping on a nail.
Ooh.
Now you gotta get the tetanus shot.
Yeah. Oh, shit. That just hurt me just now.
That dude about to jack his foot up.
That just hurt me now.
Damn, nail.
That just hurt me now.
You got some long ass toes, dog. God dang.
We ranking the worst thing.
That nigga got some red polish.
That polish on his chin. That might be a female. That's an ugly female feet.
Nah, they like a man.
Stepping on a nail. And last but not least, you're messing around, you ran outside to take the trash out of something, and you just stepped in some shit. Stepping in shit. I want y'all to rank the worst things to step in. Rank them.
Cause you know what's crazy is that, you know what I'm saying, with this this shit situation.
It's a shitty situation.
Right, but see, the thing is that if you step in with your shoe, then you can just take your shoe off and leave it outside and then eventually go back out and, you know what I'm saying, wipe it with water hose. When you step in barefoot and shit, nigga, you can't just sit that shit outside. Nigga, you coming in this with this motherfucker. It's been a while.
I don't even step in grass no more. I'm straight country.
But the worst shit to step on.
Worst shit to step on.
Definitely.
Right.
That motherfucker Lego piece, dog. I do not want to fucking step on a goddamn toe.
I mean, better step on a Lego piece than a damn nail. I know that.
Yeah. Well, you know what? I take that back. Yeah. You're right. You're right. I'm gonna set a nail. You're right. I'm gonna set a nail. I'm gonna also take that back. I'm gonna set a nail then shit.
What's up with I do?
I'm gonna set a nail then shit. I'm gonna definitely set a nail then shit because it's
nail shit.
Because it's hard to get it's hard to get shit out. You know what I'm saying? It's hard just to get the smell out. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna say nail then shit.
Okay.
Then I'm gonna say the toys, then the wetness. And then the scale. The scale is not my biggest problem. I can step on the scale all day. I ain't got a problem.
E, what you got? Worse.
Worse is the nail. Then it's the scale. Then it's the wet. Man, you stepping so wet and spot that shit.
The worst.
Ugh. You like, what the fuck y'all feel? I don't even give a fuck about it. Man.
Just like about us spilled that Kool-Aid.
Lord, sticky in the mood.
Oh, let's see. What else? The Lego piece.
Scale.
Then the scale. Yeah,
shit.
Scale.
Did you say shit?
Nah, you got shit. Shit is after the scale.
Shit after the scale.
So you got nail, scale, shit, wetness, toys. Okay. What you got?
Definitely the nail. Cause that shit, that looked like that hurt. Give me nail, shit, toys, wetness, scale. Be honest with yourself. Get on the scale, that's what you weigh. Right, okay. Whether you see it or not, it don't matter.
Not for real.
And that's this evening's ranker, man. Appreciate y'all, man. We just trying to figure out preference, man.
I got my whole captain ready if you
let's do it.
If y'all ready to take on that challenge.
Oh, you got the Who's Camera? Okay, let's get it. Let's get the Who's Camera. I'm taking on the challenge. It's not a bet, but I'm taking on the challenge, though. I'm taking on the challenge.
Now, so with the Who Camera, what we do, I give you two articles. Okay. One sentence from each article. You got to tell me if it's fact or cap.
Okay.
So I'm just going to jump right into it. Number one, called Meta Parents. Mark Zuckerberg has recently announced that since he wants the metaverse to appear as real as possible, he will make it so you can have a meta baby with anyone just like real life. Meta Parents.
A meta baby. Okay, I got you.
Yeah. Tesla talk. Tesla's updated service now comes with a megaphone feature where you can talk from your car with outside speakers to announce to pedestrians instead of using your horn. Tesla talk.
Okay, repeat that one more time for everybody that may be joining just now. You know what I'm saying? And then everybody know what I'm saying. If you know what I'm saying, if you're watching on Instagram, you know what I'm saying? Instagram is back up now, so you can watch on there now. So repeat what you just said.
All right, so I'm giving you two stories, one sentence from each article, and you have to guess whether it's fact or cap. Okay?
All right,
now do it.
All right, so the first story is entitled Meta Parents. Mark Zuckerberg has recently announced that since he wants the metaverse to appear as real as possible, he will make it so you can have a meta baby with anyone just like in real life. Meta Parents. Story number two.
I'm over here thinking like that.
Tesla talk.
How you gonna make a baby?
Tesla's updated service now comes with a megaphone feature where you can talk from your car with outside speakers to announce to pedestrians instead of using your horn. Tesla talk. So I need to know who's capping.
I'm gonna go ahead and say neither one of these make no damn
It didn't. So I'm gonna
they
say
both sound like a bad idea.
See, I always come with the criminalities and the food. So now you gotta think.
I'm gonna say both of them capping. I ain't gonna think about it. No, since I'd heard the George twice. I'm gonna say both of them capping. I'm locking it in.
I feel the same way. First of all, they're like, you knocked in. Who wants to be a millionaire? Cause how the hell are you gonna make a baby? What's the baby gonna look like? They gonna blend y'all together, I guess.
Right.
Or what, does the baby got their own page now? I don't know. I'm confused. And secondly, Tesla being able, I've always said this, it'd be a damn good idea if you can just talk to these motherfuckers instead of honking. If they don't know what you're honking, you're like, hey, you had the green light. Hey, go, man. But you know how ridiculous it's gonna sound if everybody got that? It's just gonna be cars talking to everybody. Get your ass across the street. You know what they want? You know what I'm saying? Hey! Niggas gonna be hollering at girls from the car and shit. Hey, baby!
Shot in the red. Hey! You one walking bitch! What the fuck you in?
I'm gonna
go with both of cap, man.
Yeah, I'm gonna go both cap.
Ridiculous if any one of those.
Let's say anybody online, anybody else?
Talisa said Meta Parents is cap. Tesla talk is true. Yeah, she said.
15 said they both capped.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Definitely let us know how you feel. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, let's get the verdict. Let's get it.
All right, well, when it comes down to Meta Parent, Mark Zuckerberg has recently announced that since he wants the metaverse to appear as real as possible, he will make it so you can have a Meta baby with anyone, just like in real life.
A Meta baby.
That is cap.
So far, so good. Yeah, I got it in. So far, so good.
Now, story number two, Tesla talk. Tesla's updated service now comes with a megaphone feature where you can talk from your car with outside speakers to announce to pedestrians instead of using your horn. That is fact.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's a feature. It's not replacing the horn. But it's
I have to think about that. I could see Tesla doing some shit like that.
Man, that would be the dumbest shit.
It's done.
Wow. They already got it?
Yeah, it's out.
And all the Teslas.
And it's super clear.
It's a feature that you get.
Yeah.
Because, you know, cops had it. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, pull over. Get your ass out the street.
Man, I feel like somebody in my car.
Well, no, you're the voice.
No. See, you inside your car.
You talking to people outside of your car.
You set the instead of horn, you put it on megaphone.
Uh-huh.
And whatever you say comes outside.
Oh, get out the way, you little bitch.
Yeah.
You can really move, bitch.
So, you know what? It'd be crazy, though, because you kind of don't want to set it on megaphone because you know how you be like, you'll pass someone like, damn, this motherfucker, get that going slower. Then they hear that shit, you know what I'm saying?
Get the shit on.
Right. You get the shit on like, oh, shit, they heard that.
Niggas gonna be in the driveway. What's taking so goddamn long? Shit. Get your food and go, goddamn.
Niggas show me like that. Like, what your ass doing? You know what I'm saying?
Niggas driving. That's why I hate coming with this bitch, man. Get off your ass and do something.
They can't have the right one gonna have that feature.
Right,
he talking all shit.
Right, for real, the right one gonna have
y'all
that.
Y'all recently seen the update on Facebook? One of my friends got a Tesla. She updated her car. Like, we got a megaphone on it, bitch.
Get the hell out of here.
That is fire.
I'm gonna be all over the state. Turn your signal off, goddamn. Where you turning at? Where you turning? I don't know you're going left, right, to the side.
Oh, man.
Hey, slow down. 12 up, y'all. My way is just over.
Right. Oh, man. Well, we appreciate that, man. We appreciate the Who's Capping from Mr. E. Cow, man. You know what I'm saying? And we definitely know what I'm saying. We'll keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? To the last part of our show, Big Talk, Big Game. And this is the moment that we call the mini versus.
Ooh,
we call it the mini versus. So it's about to be a whole new year, y'all. It's about to be a whole new year, you know. And on this mini versus, we about to turn up the last mini versus of 2021. So there's no better way but to go out with a bang, to go out on top, to go out with a good versus, to go out hype in this bitch. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? So the verses today, and it's a good one, y'all. Young Dolph versus Moneybagg Yo.
Okay.
That's gonna be lit.
Okay. They both sound the same.
Okay. R.I.P. Young Dolph.
They both from Memphis.
They do sound the same.
They got
a
little.
They both was kind of beefing one.
Yeah, they
was kind of beefing.
They both got a frog in them.
They both was kind of beefing, you know what I'm saying? So we got Young Dolph versus Moneybagg Yo. Who are you picking right now?
Dolph.
I really like Moneybagg Yo.
That nigga Dolph be like, hey!
I'm gonna pick Moneybagg Yo.
I like Young Dolph too though.
I'm gonna pick Moneybagg Yo.
That's exactly how I watch my kids.
I'm gonna pick Moneybagg Yo.
Feel loud noise. Hey!
Yeah.
I'm gonna pick Moneybagg Yo. You know what I'm saying? So who are y'all picking? We got Markin that said, oh wow, Talisa said Moneybagg Yo.
What?
Markin said long live Dolph.
Dang, I'm torn on this one, actually, y'all.
What we got on Instagram, what they saying? We got Young Dolph versus Moneybagg Yo in the mini verses. We're going to give y'all mini verses here. The last verses of 2021 from Big Talk, Big Game. If this versus was to happen, Young Dolph versus Moneybagg Yo, who are you going with?
Give me Dolph. Man.
I'm going with Moneybagg Yo. Young Dolph is up first to bat. Here we go.
Young Dolph.
Oh, song number one by Young Dolph. Dolph.
Yeah.
Young Dolph, 100 shots.
Hey, we lost a lot of people this year, man. R.I.P. Dolph.
Yeah, R.I.P. Dolph, man. R.I.P. Yeah. Young Dolph.
That's the first. You know, these niggas love to talk.
What you say? What you say? What?
Yeah. Everybody screaming, gang. Who's come and get you? You gon' tell on the whole gang. She said, can she fuck me with my diamond chain?
Gang.
If I ain't in the bank, then I'm on the brain. About to go get some money. Yeah,
here come that beat.
They stuck me in the airport, had too many bitches on me.
Yeah, this song is an interesting song, too.
They don't want you to pop.
You gotta know Young Dolph for this.
Then they pray for you to fall. Hey, young niggas, stay focused.
Ooh, I'm talking about
the crash. Think about where you at.
Yeah.
Then think about your past.
What?
I really came for shit.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna transfer shit.
That beat about to drop, y'all. Here we go.
This song is special, boy.
Young Dolph, 100 shots. Song number one by Moneybagg Yo. Moneybagg Yo, me versus me.
Moneybagg Yo, I'm looking at my boys, the name of my girlfriend. Hilarious.
We got round one. What you got?
I'm going off round one.
I'm gonna go Dolph round one. Round two. Here go Young Dolph, round two. Young Dolph, preach. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no.
You can't sleep
on that.
Hey,
well,
this
you already know what it is. Young Dolph, preach.
Me and your legend, that dog preach. When he got to say, let's go. That ain't shady.
What?
Wanna have a baby.
What?
Crack baby.
What?
Street,
hey. We got a lot of people saying Young Dolph round one.
So I got it off the block. Hey. What he said? See the nigga get shot.
Damn, damn.
Here go number two. Money bag, yo.
What's that nigga telling on his own pussy?
Okay, hold on.
I thought a broke nigga said something.
What? Huh? You listen.
Hey. Ooh. Ooh.
Look at the head and neck movement. Get low with it then. Get low with it then.
He disappeared.
That's that money bag, yo. Said something.
Hey,
I'm gonna go let y'all know. Moneybag got this for me. This right here, dog. He got this for me, dog.
On preach?
Yes, on preach. Moneybag got this for me.
I'm still going, dog.
Preach? Yep, I'm saying it. Said something. What? They said nothing. Running up, running up.
Play preach in the club. Everybody, word for word.
Play this in the club.
Bar for bar.
Play this in the club. Song number three by Young Dolph.
Hey,
Young Dolph, major.
Yeah.
Hey, for the summertime, got a new truck. Hey, trapper slash rapper slash bad bitch. Now she come out, baby mama mad. She said you live like a bachelor. So I'm sold 100 pounds and got 10% to the pastor. Church, keep going up the ladder. And they may make a matter. Hey, oh. Tell myself when I'm gone, you gon' be a rich little bachelor.
Let's go. Song number three, by Moneybag, yo. Moneybag, yo, big facts. Money bag, yo, big fat.
Who you got? got on Little East. I am too, actually.
Yeah, Money Bag got this for me too.
Money Bag.
Gotta be. Song number four by Young Dolph. This is some of Young Dolph's biggest hits.
Okay.
Money Bag don't got stuff to slow. He ain't got nothing slow. Money Bag get you.
Got a
the biggest hits though. I'm telling you. So it's like he ain't got nothing like that consistent like Young Dolph. Young Dolph always got something that's like slow like this, rapping and whatnot. Money Bag got something that's gonna make you, you know what I'm saying? Like most of his cuts is like this, you know what I'm saying? Young Dolph only got a limited amount of like this. Young Dolph is like this. That's why I say, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna be hard to find somebody to take. Song number, that's Young Dolph forever. Song number four by Money Bag Yo.
This is my ass for when it came on. Damn, damn.
Money Bag Yo. Way too much.
I got a thing for me. So
he just got stuff that's just gonna make you, get like this all day.
See, Money Bag, he be saying shit. His hook be shit like you be saying. Like, I thought a broke nigga said something. You know what I'm saying?
You gotta really know.
Marcus said, y'all won every one of them.
I
he said, don't want every one of
them. Money Bag, yo, we saying shit. Nigga, talk about for real.
Here we go.
You be talking to your homie, man. You be doing too much, man.
Song number five by Young Dolph.
Wait, let me point right here, though.
Song five by Money by Young Dolph.
Here we go. There we go. Put them back in the game. Huh? Get them
paid. Young Dolph, get paid.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do?
Young Dolph be teaching left.
Here we go, song number five by Money Bag Yo.
Okay.
I told him Money Bag Yo got the song. Does it make you just get hype all day?
Nice little round right here.
Like you said, Money Bag, you'll be like, talk about some real shit, but I ain't got time for that, man.
Yeah.
I ain't got
broke.
Come on, now. You see what Doc said? Shot says, get paid. Don't pay one. It's over.
You paid one that round. Because, see, don't be giving me lessons. Moneybag Yo just be talking shit like you and your niggas talking shit.
Look, all like bitches, don't like bitches, don't like. You gotta like somebody.
Man, I got it 4-1. Moneybag Yo. I got it 4-1. I got one more song for y'all. One more song, just to see. Last song. Last song by Young Dolph. Yeah. Let's see. Last song by Young Dolph.
Play me some Pippin, man.
Baby.
Like now I'm gonna wait till Young Dolph, R&B.
On the way to the crib, I'm playing that goddamn Dolph.
Oh, man.
It'll be lit, boy.
Yeah.
What'd you just say? Like,
Yeah. Drive my limo like a Chevy on some rich nigga shit. Hey, can't talk to my girl, she a rich nigga bitch. Told her something I was gonna be on the rich nigga
list. Fuck you, Paul Mack.
You need to do that next guy.
That shit made me wrong, man. God damn. Listen, man, that dog gonna make you want to scam, bro. Hey, who you back with? You talking about money? Who you back with?
Hey, here we go. Last song by Moneybagg Yo.
Bank of America, boy, and it is the big thing. I didn't want too bad, not whatever you get. Oh, you got to believe it. You play it. Nobody's
business.
Oh, man. First thing first, Phil Papa, Jake always matched. Come on now. How can you remix
Biggie
like that? That shit was hard,
man.
I probably should be
thinking. Like, I'm sitting here looking at Keisha like, do you love me? Do you love me not? Damn, hit the spot. Taste like candy. Sweet like fruit. Wet like water. Can I love on you? I'm drunk. I'm feeling different.
Oh, you dad,
I got
4-2.
I got 4-2. Yo. I got 4-2, yo. 4-2, yo. So, no, saying that was if that versus was to happen or whatnot. If that versus was to happen between Dolph and Moneybagg Yo, that's why many verses. Who would you have picked or whatnot? You know what I'm saying? Well, we definitely appreciate everybody watching Big Talk, Big Game, ending the year off of 2021. We're going to celebrate the new year, man, 2022.
Y'all have a safe New Year's.
You feel me? Man. And definitely keep and stay tuned to Big Talk, Big Game. Make sure you subscribe and follow us on all social media platforms, man, because I'm telling you, like we always say, we got some big things popping, man. I'm telling you, Big Talk, Big Game, in cahoots with the Hip Hop Network, man, definitely. Make sure you subscribe to Hip Hop Network today, too, as well. Become a citizen, man, I'm telling you. It's big things coming.
The shit lit, for real.
I'm telling you, big things coming. Because like we always say, you better get on the train now. Because when the train get to moving, it ain't going to probably be no more seats.
You're going to want
to
be on
I'm
that
trying
train,
to tell man. You, man. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be hard to catch up with that train, man. So definitely get on that train now, man. Once again, this is Big Talk, Big Game. This is your boy, D-Rail.
And I go by the name of Lee. What up?
Hey, man, like always, we out of here. Hey. Peace.